Well, here I am, Tim Ostendorf, back again with more Joan Sutherland. It's been a while since I've done these. Why do I always have to start with that? Because it has been a while. And of course, we're in the middle of the COVID-19 virus scare. It's lots of fun. So I'm stuck here. And I'm not at the Inn at Crystal Lake, although my partner Bobby and I do still own the Inn at Crystal Lake. I've only done one video in my new location. We did buy a house in nearby Freedom with the hopes of getting a wedding venue up and running. So there's a wedding venue video on here about that, and we're currently fighting with the town, so that's a lot of fun. But anyway, I'm a baritone, owner of the Inn at Crystal Lake in Eaton. Been there for almost 19 years. Started doing these videos 45 or 6 years ago. So I've aged a bit since then. Things are a little whiter, hair is a little whiter, mostly white. Of course, I just found out that this undercut cut, I guess that's what they call it, the high and tight, whatever it's called, is now out. It's out for 2020, now that I finally got this cool cut, right? I guess I'm too old to be a hipster, but I got the tattoos, so, whatever. Anyway, normally what I do is talk about Joan Sutherland, but of course I can't ignore this virus thing that's going on where we're all stuck. But this is my new little studio here, my little opera room. I have my own little bed there for when my other half is snoring, you know what I'm saying? I got a cute little piano that will I'll probably never get tuned because it's so old and all the strings will break, but I've got all my Joan Sutherland around and sorry, that goes out to the sleeping porch. Let's see, I've got let's see, what else I can it's hard to see where I'm looking here. Oh, so yeah, I've got some Phyllis curtains, some lots of Joan, of course, all sorts of things going on. It's really sunny out today, by the way, which is interesting because it feels like it should be gloomy and cold and rainy, but it's beautiful out. So I'm still working with the lighting and everything. I have this cute little. I have this little fireside. Let's see. We can have a little fireside chat. So I'm usually not one for the fake fireplaces, but that's just too damn cute. And this house is kind of big, so sometimes it's cold and I need a little extra heat source. You know what I'm saying? And so anyway, as far as the virus thing, can't get the haircut, so it actually was a lot shorter before. So I'm using every possible product. Can't get the haircut because the barber's not open. So I got Jabril cream. By the way, I'm not getting any endorsements from any of these products. I got your L'Oreal Studio line. Just in case. I'm wearing all these, by the way. Got your Got to Be. It's a kind of it's a pomade. And then to finish it all off, yes, I'm very not very friendly to the environment. I'm sorry. But it's just a light spray. It's an easy mist, so it's not a heavy duty. I'm not totally killing the atmosphere. But yes, Aquanet. And it's a little too early for cocktails. It's not even 2 o'clock here in New Hampshire, so I've got my vitamin water. 0 calories. Some of you may also have noticed that I actually, since I started doing these, and since about last year in February, I've lost 30 pounds. That's right. I had to go buy all new clothes and all that. So anyway, that's enough about me. Instead, let's get on. So as far as the virus, back to that, right? So I'm just trying to do all the normal stuff. Thought I'd get back into doing my YouTube videos because I've only done one here in my new house, and so I'm gonna try and get some more done. A little fireside chat with Tim Ostendorf and Joan Sutherland. So just trying to stay normal, getting up, still taking a shower, getting dressed, shaving, brushing my teeth. I've been doing the low carb thing, trying to stick to that, not overeat, and been binge watching RuPaul's Drag Race, catching up on old seasons and things on Netflix and all the stuff that everyone else is doing. So we're all in it, I guess. We're in the same boat, which in a weird sort of way is kind of cool. Not cool, but you know what I mean. At least we're all experiencing this. We went to the Hannafords, the local Hannaford today. It was kind of creepy. It was making me kind of sad. I almost started crying. I will try not to do that in this video. But what I've chosen to a Facebook friend in the UK asked me to do and to cheer him up to do another video. So, and I said, "Well, you have any suggestions?" And he said, "Well, what about little Bellini? Joan always was glorious in Bellini. No one can sing Bellini like Joan." And so this is from Beatrice di Tenda, her last big aria. I don't know if you, she was a real person. She was married to Philip somebody or other. I won't bore you with all the details because it's really here about the singing. We don't really care, but about the rest. But yeah, she was married to Philip, a loveless marriage. And then you have a noblewoman, Agnes Agnese, just call her Agnes by her English name here. She's actually in love with the Duke Orombello, but Orombello is actually in love with Beatrice, and so of course Philip. Sentences her to death for treason because she's in love with somebody else or blah 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 whatever. That's the basis of it. And the Orombello. Is a rather young Luciano Pavarotti. This was done in 1966, so really before he became the eventual superstar. And the Agnes is Josephine Visi, who's a wonderful mezzo-soprano, kind of underrated, more known, I think, for Wagner and other stuff, not really bel canto, but she is on this recording as Agnes. And of course, Joan Sutherland and Bonn and conducting and all that. So her final aria, as she's being sentenced, now, of course, Agnes has just fainted because of all this is going on. And she's being sentenced, you know, she's off to be executed. And she sings farewell, addio, and this her big aria starts, a se un urna e a me concessa. Don't even get me going on my Italian. That's as much as I'm going to do. And that was pretty bad, and I didn't practice. So I apologize. I apologize especially to my Italian friend, Catherine Verilli. She's going to be like, well, that was... You butchered that. But anyway, she says farewell. Oh, if I'm vouchsafed a tomb, leave it not bare of flowers and pray over it to heaven for Philip, not for me. And as she approaches the unconscious Agnes, who has just fainted, tell this overburdened girl that dying, I embraced her and prayed to the everlasting God, imploring mercy for her. And then they say, they all chime in. Oh, that's so sad and everything. And she sings it again. And then she launches into the final cabaletta, of course. And she says, I embrace you. Ah, the death I am approaching is a triumph, not defeat. Like a prisoner slipping his shackles, I leave my sorrows behind me on earth. And to the throne sublime of the righteous Lord, which I now behold with longing, I shall carry from this life. I leave nothing but your love. And she ends on a big high note, of course. And so let's get to it. It's kind of a sad aria, but it kind of fit the mood, I guess. Although, like I said, the weather is so beautiful. It's kind of like, I feel like it should be pouring and raining. And although we did get some snow the other day, but that melted very quickly. So anyway, Joan Sutherland, 1966, Beatrice di Tenda's big final aria. That was an awful lot of rambling. I apologize, but it's just been so long, and it's just me and Bobby here in the house, so it's kind of like, who the heck else am I talking to? Thank you. And of course, I just accidentally stopped it instead of pausing it, right? Oh, actually, I guess I did pause it correctly because there was the chorus right after her, that beautiful long cantilena, cantabile, whatever that's called. I don't know. And then that, yeah, so they all join in. Oh, isn't this terrible? Poor thing, poor thing. So here's that. So, but just that, those beautiful long Bellini, Bellinian, Bellinian, Bellini, Bellini-esque, Bellinianian, Bellini lines. It's just my friend on Facebook, you are right. No one can sing that like that. Even my beloved Editha, I have a recording of her doing it. Not even close. And I do love me my Then we'll get into the final Cabaletta. And I know it was very sneaky of me as I'm changing my peepers. For those of you who might follow me on Instagram, TR Ostendorf, there's not a lot of those on there. I had a whole series of peepers. I think I posted them on my Facebooks too. I don't have more than one. Well, I have the Ins Facebook. That's just kind of me being silly, Facebookses and YouTubeses and all that. So I guess I do have more than one Facebook page. It's me, Tim Ostendorf, and then the Inner Crystal Lake. Oh, by the way, before I forget, I know I'm getting my advertising in here. But yeah, I have by almost 20 or more pairs of sets of peepers, and I like to switch them out. So I just thought I'd bring a few to my video today. So anyway, as far as that wedding venue I mentioned that we're fighting with the town to get going for expand our business, which I guess is kind of good that we didn't get approval right away, because those people who might have booked weddings would be knocking on our door looking for the deposit back because it'd be canceling right now. But anyway, we've named this house because it's on Coldbrook. We call it Coldbrook Cottage. So just if you want to get an idea, we already have a website up and running called coldbrookcottage.com. So innitcrystallake.com, coldbrookcottage.com, TR Ostendorf on Instagram, Tim Ostendorf on Facebook. Friend me, I'll probably accept your re request because I like to have lots of friends because it's fun and I'm out here in the middle of nowhere and we're on virus break right now. So that's all good. All right, back to the Cabaletta.
Thank you.
fabulous is that? And see, my little piano over here that I showed you earlier, I think I mentioned this in my only other video I've done from here. My idea was to be able to then go, oh, what was that, a high E flat or something or whatever, but it's a little tuned. Nice, huh? But it's still fun to have it. It's actually kind of like my nightstand. It's like a 4-tier nightstand. So how fabulous is that? Anyway, so glad to be back. I don't know when, if I'll probably do more because I'm going to have plenty of time. Business is closed down right now. We're supposedly be able to reopen on the 8th of April, but I don't know if that's going to happen. We're applying for every possible bit of money we can get. You can always buy a gift certificate and more make a reservation for a future stay if you'd like to support us. But anyway, enough about that. Tim Ostendorf, baritone, innkeeper, owner of Coldbrook Cottage in Freedom, New Hampshire, back with Joan Sutherland, and hopefully back with more. Good to see everyone. Stay safe, okay?